Gokulraj. I'm going to present my independent project about the Gazelle helicopter, and it is project by myself Gokulraj and guided by Mr. Soundarajan. First, I would like to thank him for entire support over that and giving some ideas for this. So very thankful to them. And next, I'm going to just quote that PPT. So the aim is to design a Gazelle helicopter using a SOLIDWORKS 2020 and giving the realistic view to the helicopter by SOLIDWORKS Visualize. And the introduction about the Gazelle helicopter, it's actually a French five-seater helicopter. It is commonly used for light transport, scouting, and light attack duties also. It is powered by a single turbo mecha engine, and it was the first helicopter to introduce a fenestron tail. Actually, the other name is called for a ducted fan instead of a conventional tail rotors. So the Gazelle helicopter is used to improve the seating capacity and also lighten the weight and increase the length than the Alut 2. It is an upgrade version of an Alut 2. So the Alut 2, you can see, is like in our country we are using as a Cheta Chitek. So they are used to call us Alut 2. So it is an upgrade version of that. And this is the first helicopter to introduce the fenestron tail. Actually, it is called as a protected tail rotor. For main reason is to create this one is to reduce the losses and thrust top of the tip of the blades. So actually it will reduce the noises as well as in that backside of the duct fan. So according to that Aerotech review, this is one of the fastest transport helicopter in the world, as an eighth fastest helicopter. So this is about a Gazelle helicopter. So next I'm going with the parts which I have designed for that. So the individual parts I have designed is main body, engine body cover, tail rotor and tail body, doors, main rotor. So in main rotor, I used a swatch plate mechanism. From the next slide, I will explain with that brief. And the interior parts, which are along it, like seats, indication panel, control panel, joystick, which will take place over that. And finally, the landing skids. So the main body of the helicopter is, the main features I've used is surface loft, splines, trim tools, surface wheel, and mirror. So here you can see those main body of the Gazelle helicopter. So this is the front portion. I have just given appearance of a glass appearance like to that. And these are done by the surface loft. After that, I used and knit surfaces and make it as a solid one. So next part I'm going to design is like an engine body cover. So here the features used is splines, surface loft, wheel surface, extrude, revolve surface, fillets. These are the main features I've used in here. So here you can see this is the overview of an engine body cover. Actually, the engine get placed inside over that cover like a body. So here in the net structure, you can see here, this is an decals I used it. Actually, you can see in that photo view, in the rendering, it will be look actual real. So in this way, the air suction will be taking place, and here the engine will be the compression will be taking the in engine. After that, the exhaust smoke will be getting out of this. Yeah, not even a smoke, it's an odd gases will be getting out of that. And here you can see the pipe, it's a ducted pipe, it's a bypass pipe. This purpose is used to, the hot gas which is coming out of the engine is, again, it is bypassed into that engine for that improving the compression process. So for this purpose, they used it. And this is the main view of that main body, like engine body cover. So next one is tail rotor and tail body. In this, I've used the features like circles, spline, surface loft, swept surface, boss extrude, dome. So these are the main features I've used it. Here in the left hand side, you can see it is a tail body. On the right hand side, you can see it is a tail rotor. In tail body, I just used normal surface loft option, and I just knitted and mirrored those knitted with each other. And here you can see the dome. I created a dome over here, and I used a fillet for that. And here you can see some indication lights I have provided over that. And the right hand side, you can see the tail rotor I created with an aerofoil shape. So this is also a ducted fan. It will be get along with it. It will be visible and good in rendering. So the next part I created is a door. Here I created this door with a handle as well as the hinges. The main features I've used here is splines, 2D sketch as a 3D sketch, and extrude cut, and surface, fill surface, and as well as knit surface. These are the major tools I've used for this one. And this is all about the door. And next, this is the main hard part of the helicopter, which is usually threading the main rotor with swatch plate mechanism. Here I've introduced a swatch plate mechanism. Here the main features I've used here is extrude, 2D sketch, trim tool, knit surface, split body, fillets, chamfer, mirrors. These are the main features. And in this main body, I've created some more sub parts, like I designed more parts. One is like wing blade, wing holder, bolts, pitch control rod, bearings, rotor must rod. These are the main parts of creating those main rotor. And here left hand side, you can see the cut section of that main rotor. And right hand side, this is the whole assembly of the main rotor. So here left hand side, you can see here the red color I indicated is a ball bearing, which will be attached over that swatch plate. And the white color is a bush, like a bearing bush. And here the maroon color is like ball bearing. This will like rotate and isolate, like it will rotate around 360 and it can move forward and backward, like up and down. So here right hand side, you can see the top motion ports. I have initial and indication lights and the main hub and the rotor rock arm connecting rods for this. So this is about the main rotor. So here, main thing of about the swatch plate mechanism. In this swatch plate mechanism, the left hand side, you can see these two are the swatch plates. The upper one is an upper swatch plate and the bottom is a bottom swatch plate. The bottom swatch plate is fixed. It won't be rotating at all. It can move up and down, but it won't rotate. But the upper part will be rotating upward. So the same one here, you can see right hand side, this is an upper swatch plate and the bottom swatch plate over there. It is connected with this hub. It can move up and down, can be picked up for that. And here, this main rotor wing. Actually, I just created this airfoil shape. You can see clearly. The blue line indicates that this is an upper pressure of the air. This is an air. It flows over that wing over that. So here, the blue line is upper streamline with low pressure and high velocity. Actually, it works under the Bernoulli's principle. So if the pressure increases, the velocity decreases. The pressure decreases, velocity increases, so vice versa of the process. So here, clearly you can see the right hand side, I'm sorry, the bottom side, the red color indicates the high pressure with low velocity. So what happens in the sense, if we tilt the wing blade, like the airfoil shape of the blade to a particular angle. So their name they used to call as an angle of attack in that airfoil shape. If the angle of attack is plus 14 degree of that, then it will produce a lift force of that helicopter. If it is in a minus 14 degree of that airfoil shape of wing, it will create a downwards force, like it will be land and fall. If it is in a middle, like in the range from plus 4 degree to minus 4 degree, it will be steady place. So this way the helicopter works. So here you can see the indication of that red line for that the swatch plate. It is controlled by an joystick. If the joystick is moved forward, the swatch plate also just tilted to that particular angle and it will get moved forward either back and down. So next one is a pilot cabin. In this cabin, it consists of a control panel, joystick, lights, seats, and etc. The features used here, it is a 2D sketch, line spline, mirror, extrude, and fill surface, surface extent. These are the one we are majorly used in the pilot cabin. So the next one you can see here, it is a control panel with some decals I have used in here. The decals which I have used in here are some meters. It's like it's an every individual meters, like T4 temperature meter, fuel meter, oil temperature meter, altitude, longitude, radar. And in engine, there will be a separate, like they used to call a phase one, phase two, phase three. For each and every phase, there will be a temperature monitor. So for this temperature monitor, they created that one. And the next one is indication panels, lights, and switches for that. Here you can see that. So here a map and the radars and the other things. Here the shut off valve button and on off buttons, you can see here. So this is about the control panel of this. Then the landing skids. Landing skids for the helicopter, it acts as a stand. So it is fitted in the bottom of the helicopter. The main features used here is projection curve, sweep surface, mirror, and cut texture. These are the main features that are used for landing skates. So these are the individual parts totally I've made it for them. And here you can see then SOLIDWORKS photo view 360. Just the environment, back environment like nature one, and landed on the mountain. So it is modeled and rendered like not in ring. It is in photo view 360. So here you can see the net, the decals what I used here, you can form as a net. And this is the total view of an assembled gasser helicopter. And this is the rendering one of the next one without decals. I've used here. And one more thing I forgot to say here, I used in wipers, whiteout tube, and here this one fuel filling tank cap. And these are the blanks I used for that. And seats, joystick, these are the one. Next, this one is an rendering of in SOLIDWORKS visualize. So I just normally given those normal decals over there. So here you can see this 2, 3. And the heat treatment metal for this, actually the exhaust will be in a heat treatment metal only. So I given with that. So here you can see the indication lights and the wipers, lights and pitot tube, seats over there. The next, these are the each every month, like for the environment, I have created this gasoline model. Then the conclusion is like finally the gasoline helicopter is designed on the SOLIDWORKS 2020 and given the beautiful rendering to it. And basically, I learned and designed the swatch plate mechanism as well. This is the conclusion of me. So these are the references I have taken for each and everyone, the gasoline helicopter and swatch plate mechanism and the working principles of an helicopter. We have the swatch plate details. It consists of further parts of an like bearings or ball, center ball, and the connecting rods. Further, you can find it out here. The adapter fan and fenestrol details. In the, these two are entirely different for that working principle. And this is Allure 2 and the Allure 3 details, the previous one for that. And here the working principle of an helicopter with visualization, like motion of that. It will be clearly explained in this reference. So this is my entire project for. So thank you for the foundation.